The old Tadpole Lane to Lady Lane Junction. This new estate is just east of the road, just north of the reservoir. The sharp left curve leads to a bridge under the 419 and feeds into a new estate north of Tadpole Lane. Back via the Roman Ridge, and to the village. It was a strong easterly wind. There's the horse. There's Dragon Hill. They've got their wool on, and it's just as well. The grass is growing nicely now. They're grazing the castle. The rape is flowering now. Autumn sown cereals. I walk down that way, and I'll go back this way. On the way out, I was playing with a couple of types of sat-nav. Just now it was Google Maps, running on an iPhone connected to the Yaris multimedia display. On return, I tried the built-in map box system. The version installed was issued in February 2021, but that's not a map issue date. The map use is remotely hosted and updated arbitrarily. It is transmitted via Vodafone. It actually turned out to be reasonably good along this stretch, via White Hart Roundabout, which had a major change in the last year or so. This northbound slip lane did not exist on an older map. Observe the steep climb and the short merging zone on it. Along here, I was using assisted cruise control set at 63 Imperial, and with the truck in front, it is automatically holding back. Then when it's turned off, this car accelerated automatically. The built-in instruments are around 5% fast. Thank you.
behind me. Yes. So I kept going back. We're ready to go now. So I went back about four times. Okay, Kevin.
Here's the electric fence. It's to keep the sheep off the lawns. The lawns are being cut this way. There's a vineyard quite close by. I bought a few bottles made from their grapes. The wine is made at a winery in Gloucestershire. On the way back from Laycock, it became apparent that the northern exit from this roundabout was temporarily blocked. That little car stopped on the roundabout, and its driver got out and started running around, trying to explain to us what had happened. Apparently a motorbike had toppled over and blocked the road. After that, I was considering using an alternative route via Chippenham to the right, but a couple of minutes later, they managed to clear it, more or less. It's not clear which one it was.